Stay tuned for Spokes Dog Has-Beens.
Hot tamale, and the next day they drop you like a cold gordita. But it's okay. I'm out of rehab now. My book is out, Yo Quiero Spago. And I'm up for the lead in the movie version of
Spiritual Science. Yeah, well, then animal rights people claimed I was being abused. What? You meddling freaks! Here's a flash. Babes and beer is not abuse. Yeah, f***ing morons.
On the next Jerry. How can you find the truth? Who will you turn to for answers? Call Ushila now.
In everyone's life, there are forks that you can come to. Seasons in your life, and everyone needs some fortune-telling sometime.
Call Ushila for your free reading now. Only $19.95.
I want you to call in because I have lucky numbers for you. I want you to check on your fortune tonight, $9.95.
Did we say $19.95? If you call right now, your free reading's only $9.95.
Well, I have balls. I can see what's going on. I can help you in your life as long as you don't aggravate.
There's only one psychic for you to call. Call Ushila now.
Do not ever call Cleo. I'm the one you want.
Call Ushila now.
And we're getting a picture on the TV.
This week on Sierra Shorts, visit the National Tattoo Association and check out the body art. After Hours Jokes at the Strawberry Music Festival. Danielle Folta, Playboy Playmate, ooh. Dr. What's Science Fair, and musical guest, Local 420 Plus. Much, much more this week on Sierra Shorts. Sanford, Florida. A man went to the county jail to visit his friend. While waiting in the lobby, he lit a joint, or a marijuana cigarette. Jail officials arrested him as soon as he exited the lobby area. He also had a little problem with the half a pound of marijuana that he had on him. Why do you think they call it dope?
Lebanon. Doctors have operated on a guy to remove 39 metal and plastic knives, forks, spoons, and even lighters, which he swallowed over 1 year. What finally put him over the edge to the hospital? He swallowed a piece of water pipe last week.
We're at the National Tattoo Association show inside the Reno Hilton, and as you can see around me, there's lots of tattoos and lots of purveyors of tattoo materials. So let's go meet some of these folks. Let's go meet some of these folks. This is Vince, he's from The Vanishing Tattoo, and where are you from?
We're from Vancouver, Canada. I'm working with renowned Canadian tattoo artist Thomas Lockhart, and we're actually making a documentary television series on traditional tribal tattooing. And if you look here, you can see this is the way that they used to tattoo before electricity, where they used to use hand poking in Japan, hand poking in Borneo. This is the roots of tattooing in the West.
Would you happen to know approximately when the first tattoo was found?
The oldest example that we have of a tattooed person is Otzi, who is the Austrian iceman found in the Tyrolean Alps, and they carbon dated him to 5,300 years old, and he had 15 tattoos.
Why do you suppose they found the tattoos and not his testicles?
I'm sorry?
Why did they find the tattoos and not his testicles, the iceman? Where are you from?
Salt Lake City, Utah.
Now, I have a question for you about your tattoo. Are those Japanese or Chinese characters?
It's Japanese. Kanji. Japanese.
Kanji.
Yeah.
And what does it say?
It's my mom's name, and then it says mother underneath it.
Right. Are there a lot of people with tattoos in Salt Lake City?
Yeah.
How many people in the Mormon Tabernacle Choir have tattoos?
None.
Leaving fear. They don't understand why she doesn't leave. But I remember when the deserved blows reinforced the loathing, when death was a door and mirrors reflected only embarrassment, when shame was worn like a mask I couldn't remove, when I was too small to scream. I remember the day I left fear. Unlike Lot's wife, I never looked back.
Say, what is a
what
fly's
is supplies best pickup line?
Pardon me, is this stool taken?
You're the wild ones feeling my veins. All I can do is try again and wait.
A mushroom walks into a bar, and the bartender says, sorry, we don't serve mushrooms. And the mushroom says, but I'm a fungi!
You're hidden deep down where waters run cold, and little did I know.
In the dull and commonplace occurrences of day-to-day living, one thing stands out as a completely unique experience.
Hi, I'm Chiquita Pequeña Panzona, and I'm with my best friend today, Dr. Linska Petrova.
Hello.
We're doing the health and beauty segment today. And do you know, sometimes you wonder, how can you get rid of those nasty bags under your eyes? Well, cucumbers. That's really good, the cucumbers. And another good thing is tea bags. And you put these on at nighttime when you're sleeping, so nobody's going to see you, okay? That way you don't scare nobody. Another good thing is protein. You have to have your protein. So we're choosing beef jerky this week. And that's a good source of protein. You can put it in a tortilla, a sandwich, a biscuit, just finger food, eat it how you want. Do you want something crunchy? Potato chips.
Pretty good.
Uh-huh. Wow. And another good thing is, well, there's
the best.
Something for your hair. Okay.
Pretty good.
Now this is very important. Egg whites is good for your hair. Mayonnaise is good for your hair. Another good thing is beer. Beer is very good. This is good. It helps you with all your split ends and everything. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how easy it is to do the beer. You take your comb and you dip it in the beer.
Sorry about that. Very good beer. Maybe we have more somewhere.
Well, anyway, that's what you do. But listen, tune in next time. We got some really good exercise mitts in our bikinis. We'll see you later.
Bye.
Danelle, could you tell us how you got into modeling?
Well, I got into modeling to pay for my college education, and took off. They said, oh, you have to be in Italy, and of course, who can turn that down? So I was off to Italy like a month after I started.
What was your major in college?
Pre-law.
Pre-law.
I was going pre-law to Denver University.
Right.
Yeah.
Where do you see yourself going from here? I know Playboy opens up a lot of opportunities for people.
Oh, Playboy is a wonderful networking tool for me. I've met not only, I have different things I do. I want to get into acting. I'd love to get into soap operas, that's at all possible.
Right.
But I also have little things I do on the side. I buy and sell real estate, and I have a little, I sell corrugate boxing, and it's wonderful to meet. It's just networking, and I've met so many wonderful people through it.
Now, you grew up in Indiana, which was a wholesome heartland type of environment, and you chose to live back east instead of Hollywood. Why was that?
Oh, you know, back east, people are really real and wonderful, and you know where you stand with them. And you go out to Hollywood, and it's wonderful and beautiful and glamorous, but sometimes you don't know where you stand, and I'm so blunt, you know, and I have to know where I'm going and what's going on, so.
Where do you go from here, from Harris?
I'm going to New Orleans.
Fun.
Yeah, it should be fun. And then I'm back east for a couple days, and then who knows? Who knows?
Where do you see yourself 10 years from now?
10 years from now, I see myself having about 20 kids. And
only 20?
Yeah. I just see myself, you know, a better person with a lot more knowledge and hopefully a little richer on the way.
Right,
yeah.
There you go. Well, we wish you all the luck in the world.
Thank you very much.
So much for the interview. It's Mike Bosick for Sierra Shorts. Car chase with a twist. The guy was pretty easy to catch up with. The police say that's because during the entire half-hour chase, the guy never failed to use his turn signal before making the move. Says the officer, we knew exactly where he was going.
Here's a bizarre story from London. A British woman says she cured her chronic fatigue syndrome by resorting to do-it-yourself brain surgery and drilled a hole in her own head. Heather Perry did it by cutting away a section of the scalp and drilling into her own skull. As Abe Lincoln might have said, I need that surgery like I need a hole in my head.
Hush now! Hush now! I'm Dr. What, and I'm here in my laboratory with three of my students. And we're going to find out the what and the what not, and the why of things. And we're going to do some experiments, and I brought the volcano that Muffy prepared. Okay, Muffy, tell us what you're going to do with the volcano, and I'll give you this piece of candy.
I'm
going to
pack this baking soda in the volcano, then I just pour this on and it'll go.
What's this, Muffy? What are we using, Muffy, in the lab?
It's called distilled white vinegar.
What do you think of that, Sonny?
Oh, I never knew how to work this stuff before, but now I know because she told me how.
And what do you think, Muffy?
Well, I'm excited!
And you, Shorty?
Well, I never thought of that before.
Okay. Well, let's go on with the experiment. Hurry.
Gotta pour it on slowly.
Slowly. Slowly. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, Sonny. Oh, my goodness. My goodness. Oh, Muffy, you get the candy for sure. You get the candy for sure. What do you think of that, Sonny?
Oh, I never knew how to do these before, but now I know because you told me how.
And what do you think, Shorty?
That's what I thought
about before. Muffy, what do you think?
Well, I'm excited!
Oh,
it's
wow. Oh.
You think
it's
really cool?
Dr. What? This is Dr. What from the lab with my children.
I feel like this in the morning when I wake up. Press pot ritual. Morning, and I grind coffee, thick, warm earth. Wafts the kitchen, water rumbles over flame, glass carafe raising to fold grounds with royal, where we meet, coarse layer first, then finds quiet, turn by deeper turn, hung on dark warmth.
Welcome to our show. I want to invite you to call in for a fortune reading tonight with Ushila, which is very special. And there I am. Just on time. I cannot believe it. Let me get that. Yes, this is Ushila. Can I help you?
Hello. Are you aware that you may be paying entirely too much for your long-distance phone calls? Our research indicates that you...
That's Ushila,
reduce your monthly telephone bill by taking advantage of a special calling program we are making available to a few specially selected telephone users such as...
I have been thinking about that, because I do call around a lot.
Each
what,
year,
what do you have,
telephone users overpay millions of dollars for their long-distance calls. Why? Because many are unaware of the exciting savings now being made available to them by one of the most trusted and respected telecommunications corporations in the industry. NTCC has maintained that trust and respect with innovative technology and superior customer service for nearly a tenth of a decade.
You aggravate me.
Call 1-800-992-9392, extension 2342-3242, and say goodbye to expensive long-distance calling forever. Because here at Transgrid, we care about you. Because Transgrid means caring. Thank you for listening, and don't forget to call 1-800-9...
I don't know. I think I could like him, and I have his extension. I might want to give him a call, because I am sort of looking around for a little love interest, you know? I could find him interesting. He doesn't have a very good job, though. I don't like anybody that works on the phone. Okay, good night. Thank you for paying attention. Thank you for not aggravating me, except for, you know, that guy. But I'm going to check into it, because I had an extension. One moment, please.
Yes.
And the first one turns to the other and says, "This tastes funny."
You heard about this Indian that had two wives and two different homes?
No.
It was a two-tent situation.
No, no, wait.
It's movie reviews with the Chroma Fish.
This week's video review is on The Perfect Storm, and from where I swim, this is just about the perfect movie. It's about these evil people who sail out in the middle of the ocean and capture, slaughter, and mutilate hundreds of innocent, defenseless fish. But just when you think they're going to get away with it, a big storm comes up, and then the fun begins. There's about as much water here as you could want in a movie, and you'll be slapping your flippers when the bad guys find themselves up the creek without a paddle. I give this movie 2 fins up, but the fishing scenes might be a little scary for the small fry. And that's this week's movie review with the Chroma Fish.
It's movie reviews with the Chroma Fish.
Ocean City, Maryland. A 23-year-old guy had the hiccups and just couldn't get rid of them. Finally, he asked his friend to punch him in the chest. He did, but he killed the guy with the hiccups. But at least the guy didn't have the hiccups anymore.
In Minden, Nevada, a woman ran into a police station asking for protection from her husband who was chasing her. She was told to be seated in the waiting area, but before police could get to her case, they found the couple outside in the parking lot facing off with each pointing a chainsaw at the other.
Dull and commonplace occurrences of day-to-day living, one thing stands out as a completely unique experience.
Visit to the other parent. On my couch sits your soft brown bear, wearing Christmas on his heart. He growls at me when you're not there to help him sort the crayons out.
Stockholm, Sweden. Customs officers arrested a woman who had tried to smuggle 75 live snakes in her bra. The officers became suspicious when they noticed how the woman kept scratching her chest.
The Leaning Tower of Pisa leans no more. Well, okay, it's not quite like that. But scientists reckon that it has stopped tilting further downwards for the first time it was built 800 years ago.
Welcome to Miss Vicky's Secrets. Welcome to the therapeutic part of Sierra Shorts. I have a young man here that's suffering from a very terrible thing. It's terminal flatulence. If you don't know what that is, it's nonstop gas. It's ruining his relationship. He has chosen to be here incognito because his divorce is headed for they're going to the courts. It seems as though, Fred, can you tell me just a little bit about this? I may be able to help you.
Well, I don't know what the problem is. I mean, if my wife loved me, she wouldn't mind it. I mean, what can I do? I can't help it. It's in me.
These are not trial-sized farts, Fred. You've gone to major events. You've taken her to big, heavy, large dinners. And this is how you're going on. You leave her standing there to make her look like she's done it.
Well, I don't walk away.
But you stink, Fred. That's the
whole
point.
Oh, come on, I haven't had cheese or anything like that
today.
No,
you have had cheese. These are not just buffalo farts. Fred, these are rhino farts. I'm sorry.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
Listen, you've got to think of something with love and trust you could maybe hold back.
How? I've tried that.
I think maybe the best thing for you to do is put some kind of cork up your butt, for God's sake. This is disgusting, Fred.
I don't think I could do that.
Excuse me, folks. We've got to go to a commercial, please. I've got to get some air.
Hello!
losing my ways. My conversation was about forgiveness, but you didn't know I had sinned. You sat on the edge of the bed with a cup of coffee as salvation, trying hard to understand, to drive my demons away. Then for a moment, your eyes frightened them. The dark coffee drowned them. And still I want to lie here, avoiding the eyes in the pine ceiling.
You're the wild ones feeling my bait. All I can do is try again and wait.
What do the fish say when they hit the concrete?
What do the
Damn!
Fish?
That's not funny at all. Why did the pervert cross the road?
I don't know, this is not my
say, why did the pervert cross the road?
Stuck in a chicken.
You're hidden deep down where waters run cold and little did I...
Michael, I'm standing here at Ground Zero, where the towering Mapes Hotel once dominated the Reno skyline until a series of explosions on January 30th, 2000 left only a smoking pile of rubble. The debris has long since been carted away, but the gaping wound on South Virginia Street still remains, a testament to the uncertain future threatening the Truckee Meadows. Though no one has yet been brought to justice for this incredible act of destruction, responsibility is generally attributed to the council led by Mayor Jeff Griffin, who, according to unnamed sources, is now threatening to gouge a giant trench through the center of this beleaguered community. Residents can only wait in terror and uncertainty. Back to you, Michael.
Tucson, Arizona. Police arrested a 41-year-old man who appeared to be trying to coax horses from the University of Arizona Agricultural Center towards him with food. Sounds harmless enough, but in reality, the food was strategically placed near the guy's exposed naughty bits.
This ain't slam poetry. Little Jack Horner at Einstein's Corner folds space beyond its curvature. He extended its line through the twist of Klein and became his own caricature.
What?
Thank you for joining us here at Sierra Shorts.
With the ranger's hat and shovel and a pair of dungarees, you will find him in the forest always sniffing at the breeze. People stop and pay attention when he tells them to beware, 'cause everybody knows that he's the fire-preventing bear. Smokey the Bear, Smokey the Bear, growling and a-sniffing the air. He can find a fire before it starts to flame. That's why they call him Smokey, that was how he got his name. Smokey the Bear, Smokey the Bear, growling and a-sniffing the air. He can find a fire before it starts to flame. That's why they call him Smokey, that was how he got his name.